All right, when you're using Google Sheets and you try to do basic arithmetic with times, sometimes it's really hard to get the right answer. We'll go over several examples of trying to add, multiply, divide, and subtract times in a spreadsheet, and we'll talk about what those kind of unexpected answers are and how to work properly with the times and you can arrive at the right answers without any workarounds. So we're going to start with a completely blank spreadsheet. And the first thing that we're going to do, we'll just go to this rectangle that's to the left of the column headers and above the row headers. We'll click on that. That will select all the cells. And we're just going to go to formatting and make sure we've cleared all of the formatting. So that's the same as starting with a brand new sheet. And that makes sure that none of these are preset to a date and time or duration or anything else that's going to throw us off. So now that we know that we're starting with a clean slate, let's just add some times. And we will add, let's say 13 hours. So to get hours, you do 13:00. That's one of the ways to get hours. You could also do another colon just to be clear that there's no seconds. We'll do that, that's fine. 13 hours and 17 hours. So we'll do the 17 here. We'll only do one set of zeros. That's fine. Google Sheets will assume there's no seconds. We'll hit enter. And then we'll come into cell C5 and we will just add the values in A5 and B5. So when I do that, I would expect to have a result of 30, right? Because there's 13 hours and 17 hours. But if I add A5 and I add B5, I get 6 hours. So on the face of it, that makes no sense, right? That's not what I was expecting. Really, the only thing wrong with how we added these is the way that we displayed the output. So all of these values are correct. We'll get more into that later. But this value in C5 isn't formatted the right way. So it's not being shown to you correctly. That's because it's formatted as a time of day, but we want to change it to a duration. So when we change it to a duration, the number of hours can go over 24. So that's very important to remember because it's no longer a time of day. So we'll go to format, go to number because this is just another type of number formatting. And we'll go down and we'll select duration. So you can even see the example for duration is showing 24 hours in 1 minute. And that's already showing that, hey, this is not a time of day. There's no such thing as 2401. And that's actually the formatting that you were expecting, right? Because 13 plus 17 is 30. And if we change C5 to duration, you'll see 30. The underlying number is still the same. It's just the way that we showed it. So let's break down what just happened there a little bit more. We're going to come down. We're going to just make a little table. And the first column is going to be format. All right. These formats are going to be number, and we'll skip down here. We're going to do time. Then we're going to do date time. And then we'll use the duration formatting. And all of these will be the same. And to prove that they're the same, we're going to use a unique function. And I'll show you how we're going to use that in a second. So I'm going to put in a series of numbers at the top, and they're just going to be formatted as just a plain old boring number. So we're going to do 0. We're going to do 1/10. We're going to do 1 and then 1.1. We will leave these all as numbers, and then we're going to take the same values. So I'll just copy these and we're going to format these as a time. And we'll talk about what happens. So we can go to format, number. When we change those to time, the 0 changes to midnight. Well, that makes sense, right? No time has passed, so that's 0. 0.1 changes to 2:24 a.m. So what that is that's 1/10 of a day. Now, when you go to 1, something interesting happens is it resets to midnight. So this unit, one integer is one day. And then when you go to 1.1, the same thing starts happening again. So one problem that you can see here when you're working with times is these two times look the same, but they're really one whole number apart. So you can see that a little bit more if we copy these again and we paste them. Going to give us a little bit more room. And we will change this row to date and time. So let's go to format, number, date, time. And you'll see that a zero in Google Sheets, when it's shown as a date and time, is shown as December 30th, 1899 at midnight. And then it increments from there. So if you do a one, that's December 31st. So let's contrast that to how durations work. So remember, these are the same numbers. I'll paste them here. We'll change them to be shown as durations. And it's different than the time in the first one because no time has passed. It's zero. But when it's 0.1, it looks the same as the time of day. And when you get to 1, instead of resetting the midnight, it goes to 24. And then when you get to 1.1, the hours just increase. So if you're following this and you're starting to understand why working with times is odd, but when you understand what's going on, it does make a little bit more sense. And to prove that these are all the same, I'm going to use a unique function which will display all of the unique values. We'll capture this range, run the function, and it only outputs a zero because that is the only value in that range. We'll put it here, and those numbers are the only ones. So hopefully that helps you to understand how these time formats, they're the same number. It's just a different way of seeing it. And that's where it's easy to get tripped up. So let's do another example. Let's come down. We'll kind of start with a clean slate here. And we're going to subtract times. We'll come up with a start time. We'll come up with an end time. And then the end, we've learned a little bit here, the end result is going to be a duration. But in this example, you'll see that when you're subtracting, you can do 2 points in time. You don't need durations like you do when you're adding. So we're going to be using a start time and an end time that are just points in time during a day. And then the end will be a duration. 10 a.m., you actually want that to be a time. So the a.m. on there indicates it's a time of day, so that's right. We'll do 3 p.m. or I could also type 300, hit enter. And I want to make sure that that's a time of day. So I'll actually capture this formatting. I'll use the format painter, come over here and there. And that actually showed that I typed that in wrong. So instead of 3 a.m., I could either change this to a P or I could get rid of that and change this to 1500. It's going to resolve the same way. So that goes to 3 p.m. And the difference between these two times, so if you look at it, you can see that's 5 hours. The way to get to that would be to start with the end time and then subtract the beginning time, right? So you're starting with the larger number, subtracting the smaller one. Hit enter, and we have another formatting issue. So remember, I cleared all of the formats, so Google Sheets is just guessing wrong in this case. So we don't want 5 a.m. We're going to go to format, and we're going to change the way that's displayed to a duration, and that's 5 hours. So the underlying number was right, but the way it was displayed was wrong. So now we are able to subtract times by changing the result to a duration. An empty spot again, and we're going to multiply some times. We'll start with the time. So this would be a duration. This would be a length of time, but we'll just call it time. And we want 3 hours. And that's the passage of time, right? So we will make sure that that is formatted as a duration. It already is, so it guessed right since the formatting was cleared. So that's good. And what we want to do, we'll call this the multiplier, is we want to take 17 times 3 hours. So I'm going to type 17 in here, but I'm not going to say 17,000. That number is less than one, right? That's the fraction of a day. I just want 17 because I want the full number. And then we'll come down to get the product. And remember my elementary years where I get these names right, the multiplier and the products, we'll get the product. And the result that we want is in hours, so we'll see what happens. B26 times B27. That's going to give us the right result. So that result was formatted as a duration. 3 hours times 17 comes up as 51 hours. So if it does come up as something that is confusing. So if that were formatted as a number, 2.131, it makes sense. But after going through this tutorial, you might be able to figure out that means 2.13 days, and you just need to see it as hours, in which case you would change it back to duration. And let's look at one more example of mixed inputs, and this would be if you are dividing times. So in this case, we will say the time that we want to divide is 36 hours. In the divisor, we want to divide it by is 3 hours. So both of these are in hours. But if you try to do it right now, I kind of purposely put in an elementary mistake here, and that these are text values. So you can see because they shifted to the left of the cell instead of the right, Google Sheets does not recognize these as numbers. And the problem is I typed hours after it. So that's not a valid time format. If you come up to the format menu, this shows you the valid formats. So you can type a time in with a PM or an AM afterward. You can do it with colons, but you can't type the word hours. Not a thing. So let's come over to the right and type 36, but when we want it to be hours, we'll have to follow it with two zeros at least. You can also put in the 0 seconds, and you can even put in 0 milliseconds. So that's 36 hours. We want to divide it by hours. You can also just divide it by 3, but that's going to be a different result, right? 3 hours is very different than just the number 3. So if we want to keep it as 3 hours in this case, we want to do at least a colon 00 after it. We'll do 2 sets so it looks the same as the one above it. And then when you divide 36 by 3, you just come up with 12. So here you have a duration, and then just a regular number, but there was no formatting applied, but Google Sheets was smart enough to know that this was a number. If this was formatted as a time, it would be noon. No. Noon? I made this whole video and it's still confusing. I'm going to wrap up this section by showing you what the 12 really is if you show it as a date and time. So let's go to format. We'll go to number. We'll show that as a date, and it's January 11th, 1900. But that does make sense if you go back to the beginning. So let me scroll up. Zero starts at December 30th, 1899. So that's 12 days after when spreadsheets start counting time. And so you're just showing it as the wrong type of unit. Leave it as a number, but so much time arithmetic comes down to just having the units displayed correctly. Noon. And if you're curious about the difference between these two values, this next video is going to discuss the different data types. So you have text, you have numbers, and there's also several other different types of data. Let's talk about it. I'll see you in that next video. Thanks for watching. It's good to have you along.